failure of cutting tools. Reasons: 1. Mechanical breakage or chipping. This is the load, mechanical breakage or cracks is found out. 2, plastic deformation of sharp cutting edge. In this sharp cutting edge, there is a plastic deformation. It is due to 1, rise of temperature, 2, lack of form stability in this form. Okay. 3, lack of hot hardness property. Okay. Now 3. Gradual wear of tool. This is a plank wear. Another is crater or tool face wear. Now I will show you the, this is the tool. This is the crater wear. This is the flank side, though this is actually flank wear. Okay. Now this is the in this way this crater wear forms. Now let this is the length, this is F and this is E. So the AC is equal to E by L by 2 plus F. AC in millimeter in this and this is L, E and F, time versus AC. The height of crater wear. Mechanism of tool wear. Abrasive wear, adhesive wear. Well, deformation on the tool face under the action of chip pressure and rise of temperature at the chip tool joint. Now you see weld formation due to the heat developed. This is tool, this is chip flow of chip. Okay. Now three. Diffusion wear, rise of temperature between tool and work surface. There is an interchange of atoms under the action of diffusion of cheap and tool materials atoms at high temperature. Okay, now number four, chemical wear and electrolytic wear. Here oxide film or coating is formed by chemical action of tool material. Now here you draw this figure. Now this is actually the HF, this is the flank wear. Okay, now HF is equal to flank wear criterion. As HF is reached, the life of the tool is over. Okay, now if in that case of cater wear, if HC is reached, then the life of the tool is also over. Now here you see HF in this direction. This is the time in minutes, T1, T2, T3 for 1, 2 and 3 phases. For the velocity V1, V2 and V3. Now T1 greater than T2 greater than T3, S and T are constants. First one is initial zone, second one is gradual wear zone, third one is destructive wear zone. Here in this zone it is most dangerous. Okay. Now let us come an important, most important chapter of tool life. Okay, tool life. It is the actual time of operation, that is time of metal cutting between two successive regrinds of tools. It is expressed in minutes, T-M-I-N-S, minutes, T in minutes. Taylor's tool life equation, VT to the power N is equal to constant, is C. B is the cutting speed in meter per minute, T in time in minutes, T is the tool life, time of tool life in minutes. N is a, it is called the Taylor's exponent, it is a index, Taylor index. Number from 1, this is 1, B to the power N is equal to C, this is 1. From 1 you can do V1 T1 to the power N is equal to V2 T to the power N. So T1 by T2 to the power N is equal to V2 by V1. Okay, or N is equal to, if you take log v2 by v1 where log t1 by t2, or ln you can do ln v2 by v1 ln t1 by t2. Okay, so n can be found out knowing all this, or you can do it n is equal to log v2 minus log v1 by log t1 minus log t2. Now in this figure, if you log graph, if you do it, log t here and log v in this direction. So this is log v1, this is log v2, and this is log t1, this is log t2. If you take this perpendicular and this is theta, so this distance tan theta will be equal to this by this. This is equal to log v2 minus log v1, and this is equal to log t1 minus log t2. Okay, so this is n can be tan theta. By finding tan theta, then n can be found out. N is equal to tan theta. Thus, n is the gradient of the line in the negative gradient. Okay. Now, if you do t versus v, and then what will happen? V to the power n is equal to constant. So actually, we can do, this is the graph of v to the power n is equal to constant. You know, this graph is very note, v to the power n is equal to constant. This type of graph is there in your adiabatic process or polytropic process, but these are values are quite defined. T is the velocity, T is the tool life, N is the index, is equal to C. Okay, so this is the graph. Let us do some problem. Problem 1. In a tool wear test with a high speed steel cutting tool, the following values of tool life were obtained. Okay, now this is the T given, cutting speed given, meter per minute. So we can just use the calculate the value of Taylor's exponent, is n, small n, and constant of Taylor's tool life equation. So from here you can, the two here, V is given, T is given, N and C is to be found out. So two equations are given. This is the, for V is equal to 25, T is equal to 30. This is the equation. Okay, this is equation number 1. For V is equal to 70 and T is equal to 1.5. minutes, this is also minutes. So 70 into 1.5 to n is, these two equations n and c are unknown, so we can easily find out. Okay, from these two equations, two unknowns. Okay, now these are all sorts of algebraic calculations which you may not need it. So this is 0.343. This is actually n index. Okay, Taylor's index, exponent, Taylor's exponent. This is answer. And C, you just put it n here or here, you will get the same C. This is a C, constant, 80.27, okay. Another problem, a carbide cutting tool lasted for 2 hours while machining. My steel work material at 45 meters per minute. Compute the tool life if a similar tool is used for machining my steel at a 20% higher speed. Number two, also, what will be the value of cutting speed if the tool is required to machine for 3 hours without failing? Assume Taylor's exponent as 0.27. Small n, so you can, for t is equal to 2 hours means 120 minutes, you have to express hours in minutes. V is equal to 45 meter per minute, so n is equal to 0.27. so from here C is equal to v into t to the power n, so C is found out. Now again, for V is equal to 45 into 1.2, 20% more. So 45 and t is equal to how much? So 45 into 1.2 into t to the power 0.27 is equal to 163.9. This is a C. Okay. From here you can easily find out t. Okay, it is 61 minutes. Number 2, for T is equal to 3 hours, 180 minutes, VT to the 180 to the power 0.27 is equal to 163.9. So, V is equal to V, what will be the V? It will be this, 40.3 meter per minute. So, this is the answer. For second part. Now this is most important. I will tell you factors affecting tool life. Number one, tool and work material condition. Cutting parameters BST. Number 3, cutting conditions, that is dry or with coolant. Number 4, surface treatment of the tools. Number 5, heat treatment of work and tool. Number 6, condition of machines and efficiency of the operator. Human error may be there, no? So that is there. Now there is a modified tool life equation. Here this is modification is that b to the power n s to the power n 1 t to the power n 2 is equal to constant. This is the modified formula for tool life, where t is equal to this one constant into this c into b, all this. Now maximum influence on tool life is due to v relative to s and t, which we have seen earlier. That is, s and t have less importance on the tool life. S and t have less importance on the tool life.